find this, finding the largest, that is the maximum temperature in particular here, how we are going to be find out. So this is the format. So where is the NCDC website, we are going to get this weather data set. And this is a format of data set. I already told you, yesterday we discussed this is a zip files, so that is a GZ, end with a GZ. Zip files, it is going to be starting and ending with the, 5 nines. Okay. So this is the raw data model. Raw data is in the form of dot GZ format. And analyzing the data, how the key value pairs. And here the data set. So see this, this is a one line. It is not going to be ended. This is a one line in particular part. So it may be, see here, here we have a dots and so on, like. So here also and so on. But in order to this, out of this data set, we are going to be consider only the year and that particular year, what is the temperature. So for that only, so see that pair, same pair, I'm going to be highlighted by using thick lines. I think it is visible, I think everyone. See this? So 1950 and 000, 1950 and 0022, and 1950 minus 0011, 1949 we have 0111. This last one is a common every data. So that is, so that a key value pairs we are going to be find out. In 1950 we have 0, 1950 we have 22, 1950 we have minus 11. So this is the one we are going to be do the input splitting. We are performing splitting. So once we are performing a splitting, by that we have some of the data. So here we can perform again, we can combine operation, because that is in 1950 we have three different data. In 1949 we have two different data. So how we are going to be merge, and that is a combine. See this 1949, and again, so here see that it is starting, we have a 1950 here and later it is 1949. Once we done this one, the reduce there, we are going to be do the combine. The combine is going to be performed along with the order, sorting order. So that is 1949, what is the two data? And 1950, what is the three data? Okay. So out of these two values, 111 is the highest value. In the three value, 22 is the highest value. Now finally we find out the total data set. In 1949, maximum temperature is 111, and 1950, maximum temperature is 22. So that is, this is the way we are going to be find out. So this is the data, and how we are going to be do that. So that is, we are going to be map function we are going to be perform. That is input splitting. Then we are going to be do sorting, and we are going to be combine. Then we are going to be do the reduce operation. By that, we are going to be find the maximum temperature. In the out of this, what is the temperature we are going to be finding the output. So that is the way. So the same diagram only in the textbook also. So now we will back to where we are ending yesterday, last class. This one, I think. So I think this is visible to everyone. So analyzing in the data with Hadoop, how we are going to analyze. Take the advantage of parallel processing. We already know that why we are doing a parallel processing. So generally we have to know about how to perform a single system operations. So if the single system operation, the data which we are going to be getting from a particular one node. So if the data is coming from various sources and various formats, so even we need to combine the various systems, input we have to take it, or output we have to take it, either we have to make a combine with the source system. So whatever it may be. So parallelly we have to process other systems also. So that is the advantage of here. We are doing a Hadoop. We need to express our queries to map reducer. After some local and small scale testing, we will be able to run it uncluster of machine. Okay, we'll run on cluster of machine. So that is what here map and what is reduce. So map reduce works on breaking the process into a two phases. That is a map phase. Another one is a reduce phase. The same thing only I taught before itself in PPT. So why again means if I show the same PPT again, you are going to be get bored. And also there the important points I mentioned here. We need to know about how to write an examination purpose. So I'm reading and again I'm explaining the same content. So each phase has a key value pairs, input and output, and and the type of which may be chosen by the programmer. The programmer also specifies two functions, that is a map function, another one is about reduce function. Two functions, map function and reduce function. The input to output map phase is the raw NCDC data. So that is a website we are going to be get the data. We choose the text input format that use each line's data set as a text value. The key is offset of being of the line from the beginning of the file. So as we have no need to this and we ignore it. So we are not going to be considered any text data. We are going to be considered about only as the integer values. The remaining values we are going to be. So that's only key value space we are going to be take it and we are going to be find out. So our map function is simple. We pull our pull out the air and the air temperature, since these are the only fields we are interested. So that is another main advantage of map function. It is going to be eliminate the unnecessary data or unused or uninterested data. So what the data we need, that we are going to be processing, that only it is going to be taken, and remaining thing will be eliminated from there. So that is which we are interested. So in this case, the map function, this data is preparation phase. Set up the data such way that the reducer function, the reducer function can do its work on its finding the maximum temperature for this year. This map function is also good to drop the bad records. So that is the thing. We are going to be drop the bad. Why? So we may have a text data, we may other different type of data in each and every line, but still we are going to be consider only the year and that particular year, what is the temperature. So we have the records of all those things. We visualize and we will see all the data here. So this is a sample format of lines. So sum of unused columns has been dropped in the to pick the page is eclipse. That is, we have see that here are the second line we formatted in the brackets. Okay. So see that here the lines are going and so on and so on and so on. So in order to make map, that is a key value pairs. So there is a zero. For example, here we have one value that we are enclosing with the eclipse. So that is a braces. So this is a 106 line and 212 line and 28 line, 424 line. Some of the lines we were considered here. So by these lines, the key value pairs of offset is we ignore the our map function. The map function is merely extract, that is very importantly, extract the year and the air temperature that indicated in the bold text in the above lines. It emits that it out of temperature has been integers. So that is an integers word. Then output of the map function is a processing of map reduce framework before being sent to the reduce function. This process is short, the group groups the key value pairs by key. By the keys. So that is a, this is a key and this is a value, that is a key value pairs. So by using a key, it is going to be do the sorting. Why is specifically doing means, so in a particular year we may have different temperature, we would not take it as this one has different values. We should consider this. That is a simple known as we must know the identical. So we don't have any duplicate values of this. Key should be one only, like that only. So we need to consider the same format. For that only, we are going to be do the sorting and we are going to be do the merge analysis. So our reduced function, we will see the following output. So we are going to be take it as 249. That is a 219.49 are there. It is going to be considered as one. And what is the data in two different datas that we are going to be merging together. That is the main duty of this reduced function. And it is going to be perform the sort also. So that is the keys in the sorting order, 1949 and 1950. So each of the year it appears the list of the temperature reading. These all the reduce function has to do how it is iterate through the list of pick up the maximum readings. So that is what the maximum value is going to be. This is the final output of maximum global temperature recorded in the year. In the particular year 1949 and 1950. So the figure which we already know that, so that is the data, some total lines, and which lines we are going to be needed for the processing, that lines only we are considered. The remaining, simply we can know that bad records are eliminated. For that we are going to be take it as a map read, that is a key value pairs. The key value pairs is done, then later we are sorting is going to be done. In the sorting, we are going to be find out the maximum temperature in a particular area, and it shows the output as. Okay. So what is your Java MapReduce? Having run through this, how the MapReduce program works, the next step will be express its code. We need to we need three things. One is a map function, reduce function, and some code. We need to run the Java. This function is represented by the mapper class, which declares an abstract map method. For example, we will see that implementation method here. So some of the Java code will be here. So in that 99, what is the maximum of the data from the particular line we are going to be taking. This is for that reading lines, we have a Java code here, this one. The mapper class is a generic type. So you know what is a generic type? Why we are considering generic type? Can anyone? Mapper class is again a generic type. So here we may have a different data in a particular defined weather data set, but we are going to be eliminate all the unwanted data. We are going to be finally consider what is the input we are going to be considered was only a text data. Not a text, for example, it is an integer data we are doing. So 1950 is an integer, and in the particular year, what is the temperature? It may be 20 or minus 11 or whatever it may be. The data is in always an integer. So we are going to be specified. So generally, the generic types we are going to be mentioned for in order to avoid runtime errors. Is it or not? Have you remember or not? In order to avoid the runtime errors, we are going to be consider these generic types. So generally we are mentioning while we are writing itself, code itself, we are going to be eliminate the runtime errors. That simply we say that which type of data which we are going to be considered for the processing, the data, what type also we are going to be mentioned while writing the code itself. So maybe while running, maybe consider the different data. So in order to avoid the such type of runtime errors, we are going to be consider it while the processing itself. That is simple, nothing but while we are going to be running the code itself, we are going to be mentioned what type of data that one. So that also we are going to be mentioned. Here only we are going to be see that angular braces. So greater than, less than symbol in between, we are going to be write these generic terms. So if possible, see this. So that is, see that output of the year, that output value is a air temperature, is an integer. So we must specify what is the type. So for that only we are going to be use a generics here. So rather than that built-in Java data types, it provides a own set of basic data types, is optimized the network serialization. So these are found in these ORG.apache. Hadoop input output package. So here we are going to be use a long writable which corresponded to the Java lang in the package we have, and int writable is also Java integer. So the map of function, that is a map function method. So here we are not going to be called as a function, here we are going to be called as a method. The map method is pass a key and a value. We convert the text value, converting into line that out input in the Java stream, that is going to be a substring method to extract the column which we are interested in. So we are going to be eliminate, how we are going to be eliminate the process. So we have two different phases are there, map phases and reduce phase. In the map phase, we are going to be eliminate the bad records, and we are going to be generate the data to what is the final data which we are going to be consider for key value pairs, that only it is going to be shown. So extract the which columns are interest. The map method is also provide the instance of constant to write the output. So this, in this case, we write the year as a text object, since just we are using a key, then the temperature is wrapped in a into writable. So again, wrapped means we are going to be convert from one data. So that is a converting from object to input or readable writable. That is a serialization and deserialization concept. So we write an output record only if the temperature is presented in the quality of code indicates the temperature reading is okay or not. So by that, so see here mentioned, this is the wrapper classes. This is the type known as wrapper classes, into writable. So that is iteratable is into writable. So integer data only is going to be considered. That data is going to be known to be writable. So again, we have four formal types of parameter used to specify the input output data. This time for the reduce function. So up to now we saw about the map function. Another one is about reduce function. The input types of the reduce function must match the output types of the map function, text and input into writable. And in this case, the output of these reduce functions are the text and int writable. So text and int writable. So we are going to be, conversion is going to be happen. So that is known as here, wrapper classes is going to be takes this conversion part. So that is a serialization and deserialization. For writing purpose, we are going to be use a serialization. For reading purpose, we are going to be use a deserialization. In the last 16-bit PPT also, we saw that row reading and row writing serialization, SCE and DEC, both operations we are mentioned, no? So same way. So record in the highest highest record with the highest count, so we are going to be used. So here we have that what the type of data, how we are going to be do by using the Java function. So for these lots of line Java code is available in the map reduce program. So in order to avoid this much code in the map reduce program only, we came into a pig and hive language, pig Latin and other. So it is like SQL statement, it is easy to understand line. That's what we need. A job object from the specification of the job, and it gives a control over how the job is run. When we run this job on a Hadoop cluster, we will package the code into a jar file. So we know what is the jar file. Its jar file is a runnable file. So once we completed our program, Java program, so simply I think you know that the previous mobiles, we have a jar code. So if you want to download some games in a previous, for example, Symbian OS, that is a Nokia phones, we have a OS. So in that phones, if you want to download Java, so whenever we are going to be start a game, it is starting, it going to be comes a Java cup, no? Java game is opening. So if you want to download, the file should be like a .jar file. So that is it is a runnable code. There is so that is the package with the code into the jar file. So which Hadoop will be distributed around the cluster, rather than the explicitly specify the name of the jar file, we can pass the job a set jar by class. So method we are going to be used and we are going to be set. So Hadoop will be will use to locate the relevant jar files by looking the jar files for containing this class. So having a constructor of job object, and we specify the input and output paths. An input path is specified by calling a static add input path and method on the file input output format, file input output path, and it can be a single file, a directory, in which case in input form all the files in the directory on the file pattern. So as the name suggests, that add input output path is called more than one use input from the multiple paths. So how we are going to get multiple lines of input, how we are going to be processed. Then the same as we have an output path, which there are only ones. It is specified the static set output path. So there we have add input path. Here we have a set output path method from the file output format. It specifies the directory where the output files from the reducer function. So this is from a mapper function, if we consider this is the reduce function. How? So we have a different lines of input are there, and we are going to be process that. The finally we are going to be get a one line output from particular whole out of data. So that is it is specify the directly where the output file from the reduce function and return. It is directly should not be exit before running the job. As Hadoop will complain and not run the job, these precisions will relevant to the data loss. Data loss means it can be very annoying to accidentally override the output jobs Java by another one. So it may be something override operations is going to be happen if it is not. So next we need to specify the map and reduce types using via the set mappers class and set reducer class method. So we are going to be use these is set mapper and the set reducer class. So the set output key class and the set output key class and set output value class methods are control the output parameters in this function it reducer. So everything which we are talking is from this program. So see that set mapper class, set mapper reducer class, and set output output key class and set output value class. So this is how we are going to be call the all the classes and how we are going to be perform the operation. So that is a program explanation. So that is it. So the inputs are controlled by the input formats and explicitly, not explicitly a set of syncs. These the default as text input format only. After setting these classes, then we define the map reduce functions. We are ready to run the job. So the wait for completion, the method on the job submits the job and waits for to finish. These methods boolean arguments is variable boost flag, variable boss flag. So this in this case job writes the information about the progress to the console. So to return the value, to wait the completion, the wait for completion method boolean, it indicates the success valid. So it is provided once it is successfully complete the job, it is provides so we know that what is a boolean. It is going to be false, a true or false value. In the sense, in the programming model, we are going to be talking about exit 0, exit 1. We are going to be, that is exit code of 0 and 1. So when successful end and unsuccessful end also we are going to be mentioned. So successful end we are going to be mentioned true, the boolean true, and failure we are going to be false as a false, failure as false. So how to test run? So see this, this is a percentage we are going to be start jar file we are going to be start. then Hadoop temperature. So somewhere we have a text file of input NCDC data, sample data we are going to take, and we are going to go. So in 11, so this is the date. So info Java JVM metrics and initialization process of Java. In the session ID we have, so we are going to be done all those things here. So information how it is going to be done. See this. So various data how we are going to be done. So file counters and map reduce works. So see that the number of bytes is readed, number of bytes is written, read operations is zero, and read operations, large read operations zero, write operations. So map reduce framework. Map input records are 5, output records are 5, input bytes. So total data, how it is going to be readed from there. So all the counters, how it is readed from there. See that when the Hadoop command is invoked with the class name as the first argument, it launches the JVM to run the class. It's more convenient to use the Hadoop than the Stripe Java, since it is a former add and Hadoop libraries, and there is a dependencies to the class path and pickups the Hadoop configurations too. So to add these applications classes to the class path, and we define the environment variable Hadoop_classpath, which is a script pickup. So where we are going to be write the code, there we are going to be get it always. So this is how we are going to be write temperature. For example, we can see this job, we are going to be add the job ID, job_local_0.0.1. So is rather than we are running the reduced task with the temperature ID, same temperature ID we are going to use, and we are going to be see that where we are going to be end that text data we are going to be read now. The first line we are going to be get it 000. Nice. And there to attempts this one, and attempts to local 11020. So knowing that the job and the task ID can be very useful when we are debugging the map reduce jobs. So how we are going to be run? So this is a cat command to run this one. So cat command output. So where we are going to be path? I think this reduce R means reduce. So see that. When we are writing an output directory, we contains output files per reducer. The job had a single reducer. Then we find a single file named as path -r-00. So when we are running this one, then we are going to be get the output. So I told you there is a two ways of two paths in old API and new API. How the different file names we are going to be mentioned here. We are going to be mentioned only R. In the new API, we are going to be mentioned RR, two R's we are going to be mentioned. So if it is old and new APIs will come, you will check. See here also we have old API. So this is the new API, it is like a single R we are going to be mentioned. So if you are running that cat output /path R reduce function from this data file we are going to be running, then the output is going to be shown like this. The result is same as when we are running through out of hands by earlier, we interrupt the saying the maximum temperature recording 11.1 degree Celsius, and the 1950 it was 2.2 degree Celsius. In old API, how the map reduced APIs, how it will be. So we have see the we already saw the differences in 1 and 2, how it will be. So 1.x how will be formally it is 0.20, and how it will be. So if possible down we have a column differentiation, we will see, or we will go through the same differentiations only. Okay, so here we have some of the lines. So how it is going to be differ from one to another one. See this. There are several notable differences between the two APIs, that is old and new APIs. The new API flavors abstract classes over interfaces, since there is easier to evolve. For example, we can add the method with a default implementation to an abstract class without breaking the old implementations of the class. For example, the mapper and reducer interfaces in the old API and abstract classes in the new APIs. So that is the one main differences. And the second one is about the new API is apache.org.hadoop map reduce package and the sub packages. But in old, we found these all those things in org.apache.hadoop.mapped. So here we are going to be use a map reduce, and here we are going to be use old one. We have a mapper itself. We are going to be find out. The new API makes extensive use of content objects that allows user code to communicate with the map reduce system. The new content, for example, essentially to unify the role of job configurations. We have told in the old APIs and to new APIs, we have a configurations. We can set it by the program itself. We have a allowable configurations are there to set it all those things. So mapper, the new API makes the use of context objects that allows the user code to communicate the map reduce system. The new content, for example, essentially unifies the role of job configurations, the output collector and the reporter from the old APIs. So in both APIs, key value records pairs only pushed into a mapper and reducer phase. But in addition, the new API allows the both mappers and reducer control the execution flow by the overriding the run method. So run method, we can instantly it is going to be run in the new APIs. In old, we have to run it separately. So that is boring. For example, the records can be processed in branches and batches, or execution can terminated before the records have been processed. The old APIs, this is the possible to map us by writing a map runnable, but no equivalent exist in the reducer. So directly we can run in the new. In the old, we have to specify which one is running and which process we have to specify that we will separate. In the configuration is being unified. In the old API path, we have especially job configuration objects and set the job configurations, and the extensions Hadoop vanilla configurations objects is used to configuration demonstrations. So we have 146 page, we have how to configuration the APIs also. So in the new API, distinctions is dropped. So job configuration is done through the configuration itself. So in the old API, it is automatically in the program itself, we are going to be right. In new API, in the configuration time itself, we are going to be complete and we can use it for remaining process also. Job control is performed through the job class in the new API rather than the old API job class. It is no longer existing. So that is the configurations or job class, client configurations is no longer existing. New APIs. So like that, we have three more. The output files are named as, that is, I told you, how we are going to be mentioned the names. Okay. So output files are named slightly differently. The old API, both mapper and reduced output named as part number. So that is five numbers we are going to be used. So same in old API, both map and reduce, we are going to be use the same name. But in new API, we are going to be use a separate name for, see that in the new API, output named as part, and then and the reduced output named as R. So R is going to be mentioned for reduce. So that is simply we can have two different, the mapper we have M and that number, and reduce we have R and that number we have separately. Where NN is the integer, distincting the part number, and starting from 00. That is how it will be zero means. So for example, if you consider a data set, so I will show you. So if you see that data set, how the zero zeros will come. Now I will show you. See that here. See that the starting will be 0 0. Always it is starting with 0 0. So by using the same classification only, we are going to be using 0 0. So for this one. So how we are going to be mention the names differently. So in a new array, we are going to be different from output and input files. Where output files, two files, the mapper and the reducer are going to be mentioned differently, and how it is going to be starting from zero. For that all, we can back end. So user overridable methods in the new API is declared through the Java. So we the exceptions, you know. So we are going to be thrown by using a Java dot lang dot integer, sorry, interrupted exception. We are going to be used if any overridable there, it is going to be given exception over there. When these means we can write the code and responsive to interrupt, so that it is a framework can gracefully cancel long runnable operations. So if it is needed to so far. So in the new API, reduce method passes the values Java dot lang dot iterable. So rather than the Java lot iterator. So I told you what is the meaning of iterator and iterable. So what is the meaning of iterator? So iteration process we are going to. So we are going to be running multiple times. So looping where we are going to be get this iterator. So in new API we are going to be use iterable. In the old API we have iterator. So that is a package name on different. As the old API does. So these changes make easier iterator over the values using the Java. See that here only is there for each loops construct. So for we are going to be used for loop, or we are going to be do the multiple times we want to run the same process. We use this iterable method. So where we have see this. It is, if you find any see this, they mention itself world maximum temperature of world. This is a world API how we are going to be use the collections. So there is a two different functions. So this, see this job configuration we are going to be doing the program itself. This is a world API programs. So sending out data flow. So MapReduce job is a unit of work that the client want to be performed. It consists of input data, MapReduce program, and configuration information. So Hadoop runs the job by dividing into a task of which there are two types: map task and reducer task. There are two types of nodes that control the job execution process: a job tracker and the name task. The job tracker coordinates all the jobs run on the system by scheduling the task to run the task tracker. Task tracker run the task and send the progress to the reporter to the job tracker. So we know this. Job tracker, task tracker, all those things. This is the two parts which we discussed in the building blocks of Hadoop. So where we have the five building blocks of Hadoop. So name node, secondary name node, data node, and we have this job tracker and task tracker. How it is going to be send the information and how it is going to be submitted to the job tracker handles how to submit to the task tracker. So the job tracker coordinates all the jobs which are running on the systems by scheduling the task and run on the task tracker. The task tracker runs the task and send the progress to the reports to the job tracker, which will keeps all the progress in each job. If task fails, the job tracker can be rescheduled and with a different task tracker. So for example, we have a different task trackers are there. The job tracker is going to be submitted to a particular task tracker. If particular process is going to be fail on particular task tracker, it is going to be used with the different task tracker to performance. So Hadoop divides the input into a map, reduced job into a fixed size of pieces. It is called input splits, or it just called as a splits. So Hadoop creates the map task for each splits, and it can run the user defined program, user defined map function, and it is called the records in the splits. So having a many splits being take time to taking a process each splits, the small compressed into time to process which whole input. If we are processing the splits in parallel, the processing better load balance, and if the splits are small, since it is a faster machine, will be able to process probably more splits is over the course of the job than the slower the machine. So even if the machine is are identical, failed the process or other jobs are running concurrently, so makes load balancing desirable, and the quality of load balance increases as a split becomes more fine grain. So on other hand, the splits are too small, the overhead of managing the splits in the map task creating being dominated the total jobs execution time. So the most jobs in a good split trend to the size of the HDFS block. So that is going to be 64 MB is the default size. All those these can be changed by the cluster, the newly created files, if specifies any file is created. So default size, how we are going to be. So how to simple only. So I will directly go to how this function is going to be. See this here. So input splits are there, and we how we are going to be do the map, and it is going to be sort, and these are sorted items. All those the sorted items are going to be sorted here, and it is going to be merged again, and it is going to be reduced, and it is going to be submitted to the. Okay, so map reduce data flow, single record task. So one record, how it will be splitted and how it will be submitted. So it is, for example, here the split zero, it may contains a different splits also there. The final output is going to be again the final output. So if it is like this, if for example, if you consider this total as a one individual system, and we can take in some different individual system, we can compute and we can take it as here as output replications. So we can take again here. Okay, so again we can do the part one and part two, we can do again the map reduce process. So for example, see this, I told you, if the different tasks, for example, we are going to do the sort here, and we have different functions are there. So two different copies are here. So we are going to be doing a part one, and we are going to be doing the part two. So how we are going to be produce the replications? So default replication size is 3. You know that how we are doing. So split zero, how the part one, split one, part two, and split two part. So how we are going to be finishing the tasks? See that. So if you consider the more data, in 1950 we have a 5 records. So 3 from one, and the second phase, the second process, we got 2 more things. Then finally we are going to be reduce, and we are going to be keep it as 1. That is, a reduce function is going to be set it all those things in 0 to. This is also in some ascending order we are going to be process. So if it is processed, then finally its output is. So out of these, what is the maximum temperature? That is, the temperature is going to be. So this is 25 is a maximum temperature. The output will be again. Then it is called with 20-25. So how it will be conclude this one means we know that nested function. See this? So max of these two. So always the max function will consider the two values only. So the max, again we have a max. The max function inside data, it is going to be divided into two equal parts. So it is a odd number. We are going to be take is three values first, again the two values second. Now again, this one, the max of 0, 20, 10. So out of this max, it is going to be 20 come out. Out of this max, it's 25 is coming out. But total max is 20. How it will be? It is simply like a nested functions. It's operations. The mean, how we are going to be fine. What is the mean? So total divided by some formula is going to be fine. So mean of that one, and we are going to be processing. So one second. So this is about how to find the mean. Specify the combiner function, partitioner functions. So that we will see in the next class. So that will be Python, all those things. This and all the book is mentioned, everything is there, but we need to know that what is the. So this maximum how to find out everything we discuss already. That's the thing only I'm going to be. So the HDFS we will see in the next class. File system. So I'll have you having this book, I think. So if not, I will send you through Google Classroom by today. Anyone having doubt, you can ask me. So 4 minutes are there.